Atmajyoti, divine light of the self. I welcome one and all for today's session called Truth and Myth. What is this suddenly change of topic? So 4 days Vaniji and Vasudevji has bombarded with the real and unreal. Okay? I hope you have got a clarity of what is real and what is unreal in these 4 or 5 days. Coming on the last day, I am left with nothing to talk. So I have to find some slot for myself.
Which is a myth.
It's a myth. So I have to find a slot for myself, create a slot for myself. If I talk real and unreal, you'll say, oh, already I know everything is real, what is unreal, I know. What are you going to say? Something new. Right? Unfortunately, I have nothing to say new. So I created a topic and I thought so we'll have some good entertainment program in this session. Truth and Myth. Okay, let us understand. What do you understand? Let me understand. What is a myth according to you?
Illusion. Something which is not real. Not real.
Myth.
Asat.
Myth is asat. Actually, myth. And you have heard of mythology? Right? So mythology comes from the word called myth. From generation to generation, something has been passed on to you as truth. That's called myth. And you live that myth as the truth. Okay, so that's how we have different God forms of God, different systems of society. Everything has been passed on from generation to generation. Okay, some generation started this or started believing that, and next generation just started following it. Okay, and today for you it has become reality. You don't know when it started. You can't question it. You start living as if it is real. Okay? The spirituality is going into the depth of the myth to understand what is truth. Otherwise, we start living in a world of make-believe. I'll just give a simple example. One example. There was a master, great master, guru. And he used to do puja every day. Elaborate puja. His puja is, people used to come and see the puja. So many, beautifully master does the puja. And when the master does the puja, One cat used to come and interfere. Okay, his puja is getting disturbed by a cat. So then master said, tie that cat to the pillar. Is it clear? Tie that cat to the pillar. Then the eldest disciple faithfully, before puja time, he will go and tie the cat to the pillar. And after the puja is over, he will untie the cat. So that one day the master passed away. Then now the next disciple, the elder disciple became the master. So he comes the next chota disciple. Tie the cat to the pillar. Okay. Then another disciple says, what happens? Why you are tying the cat to the pillar? This fellow says, this new master says, see, our old master did it. There must be some reason for that. Okay? The cat is typically called a misfortune. Apashakuna. So the master is tying the cat to the pillar to reduce the misfortune to the devotees as well as for us. So another myth has got added now. Tying the cat to the pillar is a misfortune. So, one day this cat dies. You cannot do a puja without cat. So bring another cat. Tie it to the pillar. The disciple brings a cat. The master is furious. How can you bring a cat, okay? Which is black cat. Master's cat was white cat. You have to bring a white cat only. So like that, myths get generated. And over centuries and over a period of time, this myth will get propagated and it will come to you. Okay? So now, today's session is to look at the truth and myth more closely. So what was the truth there? The cat was interfering in the master's puja. Okay? Over a period of time it became a myth. The cat is a symbol of misfortune, the cat is some black cat brings bad luck, all those things start coming. So, as spiritual journey, the spiritual journey is seeking truth. Ruthlessly, we have to see what is truth, what is untruth. But let us find out whether it is easy job. Is it easy and why it is easy or why it is not easy? So that is all, that is this session. Is it clear? Now, if you people have here, you are spending 4 or 5 days or a week here, why you have come here? What is it you are seeking? Please tell me. If you have to tell in one word, not a sentence, okay? If you have to tell one word, just one word is your only choice to tell one word. Why are you here? Tell me that one word.
Explore.
Explore.
Learning.
Explore.
Seeking.
Seeking.
Evolve.
What?
To seek the truth.
Evolve.
Evolve.
Unlearn.
Unlearn.
Real.
Real.
Feel good.
To be happy.
Happy.
Peace.
Peaceful.
Peace. Feel good.
Feel good. Right?
Liberation.
So this is the reason you are here. Okay? Liberation, explore. What is it?
Seeking.
Seeking.
Being.
Being. So if I put a question mark in front of all of this, one word, what is that?
Curious.
Curious. Why are you curious? Curiosity has not satisfied anybody's hunger.
Concentrate.
Go in front of the McDonald's. I'm very curious, what are you doing? Aha! What is there in that? What ingredients are that? Does it satisfy your hunger? Huh? Curiosity has not satisfied anybody's hunger. Right? So my question is, curious for what? Again, one question. I'm asking only one word, finally concludes.
truth.
So truth.
Because you have written
no. Ultimate truth.
Okay. I'll ask the question, why? I want to finally come to one word from this whole group. What is that one word which is there? Otherwise, everybody is coming. Everybody, see, this class has so many variety of people. I'm sure they will demand your price back. Sir, fees back. You have given a no fees written refund policy is there, no? Somebody is seeking, somebody is evolving. Right? So many varieties of desires. See, I can't satisfy so many desires, okay? Finally, I want to come to one understanding which we will discuss. My question is, tell me one word.
Learning.
Learning is already there, right?
Liberation.
Liberation. Why?
Reality.
Why? Already your husband or family members are liberated. They are, you are here. So they must be very happy, so peaceful. So they will ask you after going to the class, is there only 7 days or some more days are also there?
You seek your liberation, there we are.
Ah, we are liberation here. So, we are also liberated. So the question is, why? Why are you doing all this, spending time here? Huh?
Peaceful.
Peaceful. Right? Peaceful.
Reality.
Reality. Why reality? Huh? Why reality? Why reality?
I don't know.
Happiness.
I don't know.
See, yes, we wanted the truth.
But why?
However, we didn't even know that we wanted the truth.
Right.
Even if we wanted, there were 1,000 engagements.
Right.
And 10,000 bondages.
Right.
So, in short, we didn't know whether we wanted. So, even if we wanted, we could not have got it. So, we thought we would take a chance.
You will take a chance. But why? See, you people think that I know something. That's why I'm coming speaker here. I'm not standing here because I know something. I have come to here to understand what you are speaking. The roles are reversed here. Last 4 days, there are very learned speakers who spoke on very things. Actually, I am very unlearned. I don't know anything. I am trying to understand from you people. So it's the roles are reversed actually. I am here to listen and you are here to speak.
You come out of samsara.
Why? Why you want to come out of samsara?
You don't know.
Huh?
My thrill.
Yes, ma'am?
To thrill your mind.
To thrill your mind.
I have something to add here. But we fell into samsara hoping that was thrill in the first place.
Oh, okay. So, he says samsara is thrill.
We fell into samsara.
For a change, my question is again, please understand, when you answer something, you ask a question why again. Okay? I have only question why for you.
Destiny.
For a change, why?
I think destiny.
Destiny?
What is this?
But why did you come here?
But that is
destiny, brother. You are supposed
what
to come
nature?
Here.
Yeah. Is our real fate. Nature. We are just searching that.
A real nature.
To become better.
What is that?
Self-knowing. Huh?
Self-knowing.
Why?
Come out of that
illusion. What illusion? Why are you coming out to talk about illusion? Sometimes illusions are much better than reality.
We are fighting that
knowledge. Okay. Yes, sir.
Ignorance.
You want to remove ignorance or want to get ignorance?
Ignorance.
Because of ignorance, you come here. Fine. So now 4 days are over. Last 1 day is there. Wanted to save your peace. Only 1 more day is there.
So you are putting ideas into this.
So what did you get out of this 4 days? Please tell me. Did you get something?
Yes.
What is it?
You feel good factor you have got.
Feel good factor. Okay. So after you go home?
That will continue.
That will continue.
Feel good factor will continue.
Feel good. So to feel good you have come here. Right?
Starting point.
Feel good. Is that what you have come here? Is it true? Is it true for everybody? Everybody got a felt good after for 5 days?
Yes, yes. Certainly. Yes.
Certainly. Yes. Okay. Vani, you are lucky.
Thank you.
How are you?
So, the feeling good is called happiness. Okay? Right? Knowingly or unknowingly, all of these related to what you call as? bliss. Okay? So anything we do, we are seeking happiness in some way and trying to avoid suffering. Right? So if Vaniji tells, you come to this session for 5 days, I'll make you stand in sun for few days, 3 hours a day. You stand, I won't come. So Vaniji makes a promises, you'll feel good, bliss, good food, good, good sessions and good place. Okay, you'll feel good. So ultimately this feel good, everything translates into happiness, and happiness means happiness translates to bliss. Okay, so the bliss is a very special word. We'll try to understand that. Okay, so everything in our life, whether it's liberation, what liberation from whom? I have a suffering, I want to be free. So from suffering, if you become free, what will you get? I'll be happy. Oh, happiness is okay. No, I want to be permanently happy. That's called bliss. Okay, temporary happiness you can buy anywhere. Okay, temporary happiness you can buy anywhere. See any advertisement newspaper. Oh, you'll be happy home. Everything is happy only. Right? But bliss is something which I don't lose. Okay? The entire session or spirituality is only one word. It's called bliss. And Sanskrit word is called ananda. Okay? So entire journey of life, whether spiritual or secular, religious or material, it's only for finding ananda. So liberation from suffering, which means happiness, bliss. Explore what?
Self.
Explore myself. Where is the problem? Where the hell is problem? Okay. Seeking what?
Bliss.
Seeking? No, I'm seeking God. Why? I'll be happy. You are seeking bliss.
Finally.
God is an excuse. Evolve into what? Evolve. Oh, okay. There is an evolution taking place now. Right? Very powerful evolution is taking place, you know? Now human beings, how many electronic parts in your heart? Somebody has a
pacemaker.
Somebody has an earphone. Right?
Knee replacement.
That's evolution, no? Knee replacement. So what they say, by 2050, every human being will have average 30% of the body parts replaced by parts. Is that evolution? So your eyes will have that, contact lens. Heart will have a transplanter. Then liver will have an injection which will insulin. Pancreas, right? And kidney will have one extra filter which you can replace. The brain will have one computer processor. So compared to some 40 years back, you are a very evolved human being, is it? Are you? What is this evolution all about? From monkey to human being, we evolved. Are you want to become another superhuman being? No? After evolution from monkey to human being also, your monkey mind has not gone. Right? That's why you seek some forest and environment where you can roam around. So, what is this evolution we are speaking of? We want everything. Evolution is, I want to become better and better and better and better. For what? To be peaceful, to be blissful. The moment you are peaceful and blissful, where is the evolution? I have achieved.
I have to make others also happy.
Yeah, first you have to be, no? Right? If you are peaceful, everybody else is happy. This person's disturbance is stopped. Already peace is spreading. What happened to this person when he went to resort? Okay? Abba. So, just by you become peaceful, everybody else will become peaceful. You don't have to make somebody. Right? Then unlearn what? What do you want to unlearn? Okay, there are so many things which are causing misery to us. I want to unlearn. Why you want to unlearn? I want to be peaceful and blissful. Real.
See, we have learned that a lot of things will give us ananda. See, for example, they promise a car, but say, they promise happiness, but give you a car.
Correct.
They promise happiness.
No, no, no. They give a car with a beautiful lady on that. So you buy a car. I am not very sure. Every time in the car advertisement is a beautiful lady sitting. I am not very sure whether people are buying the car or the lady. Only picture. So everything in the life is a transaction for happiness. Okay? And at some point in come to life, we understand this bogusness, the falsehood of that. Everything what you try is shallow. Somewhere it turns out to be shallow. And it's very easy to get this thing in car. Once you buy the car, you understand that buy one, get one free is not there. But the car has come, lady has not come. So, truth. Right? Then happiness is what you are seeking. But happiness, actually a very easy thing to do. You don't have to come here. Okay? You don't have to come to this resort for happiness. You open the Times of India advertisement, first page you start happiness. Buy this latest mobile phone, you will be the happiest person on the earth, and it's only 20,000 rupees. And if it's 40,000, double happiness. See, happiness is something which you can buy. Please understand. Happiness is not spirituality. Happiness is something which you can get in transaction. Okay? Understand? Happiness is available for money. Happiness is available for is purchase. But bliss is not available. Okay? Right? Peace. Peace is something you cannot buy. Right? After 20, 25 years of marriage, you understand that. I'm sure you're very mature to understand. Peace is something which you cannot buy.
Because you made peace with it.
So, peace is not available. Peace, bliss, all they are synonyms. Happiness you can buy because it gives you excitement. You can buy. Peace is no excitement. How you can buy? Okay. Feel good. Feel good is actually, ultimately feel good is, whenever you feel good, you'll feel bad also, no? It's a package deal, no? Huh? You feel very good in this resort. After going home, oh, I missed that environment, yeah. Started. So feel good will always come with a feel bad. Okay? So, to thrill the mind, why? Why you want to thrill the mind? Huh? They're thrilling the mind is actually is keeping the mind engaged. Why are you keeping the mind engaged? So the mind is like a monkey. It's jumping around. If it is thrilled, the mind is engaged, and duration of the mind, your mind is not troubling you. That's why the children keep on playing that game, PUG, what is that, PUBG or what?
PUBG.
All those games, it keeps them engaged, thrilling. Okay, you want to avoid the troubles created by the mind.
Ignorance.
Ignorance is search for bliss in everything in life. You can get happiness, but you cannot get bliss. Bliss and peace doesn't come from anything in the world. It's called ignorance. Okay? So, if we discuss on the bliss in this session, is it okay?
Yeah.
Because I can't satisfy so many people. Variety of requirements. We'll focus only on the bliss. Is that okay to all of you?
Yes.
Who said thrilling? Is it okay? Bliss is okay for you?
Yeah, yeah.
So, ultimately, we are looking for bliss. Bliss and peace, they are synonymous. Okay? So now, let me ask the question, why you don't have it? Why you have to come here all the way? Why you have to come all the way for bliss here? I mean, is there a cafe called Bliss Cafe here? So, if you don't know what you have and you come here, will you get it?
Yes,
So, what is that bliss? And why, how we can get the bliss is the question. Okay, we are addressing in this session. Okay?
Sir, to answer your question, we had it with us, but we were too busy to look for it there.
Okay.
We thought once we'll find it out here, uh-huh. so that we remember that it is with us.
Okay. So, you have bliss, you have forgotten, and you are come here to remind yourself so that you can be the bliss all the time.
Take back.
Fine. Right? The bliss is something which cannot be lost. Happiness can be lost. Okay?
Bliss is a reality.
It cannot be lost at all. It will not something come and go. Whether you know it or not, it's already there. Okay? So the bliss is something which will not come and go. That's why it's called bliss. Ananda. It is not there, oh, I remember bliss, that's why it's there. I remember, forget bliss, bliss is not there. It's not true. Then it comes in the category of happiness. Right? So the bliss is not dependent on you remembering it or knowing it or not knowing it. Okay? Are we, so far we are in tune with the objectives of what we are doing? Okay, now let me ask you. Huh?
So once you get bliss, that is permanent?
No. The bliss is already there. It has never lost. Your mind is searching for this. That's why you are not recognizing it.
You are not reachable.
Bliss is there.
Huh?
Bliss is there.
Bliss is already there. Always there. But you are looking for something else.
More than that.
Huh. No, more than bliss, nothing can be there.
Yeah, mind has not found bliss in us.
No, mind cannot find bliss. Because, this is another challenge. The mind cannot find bliss.
Sir, when the mind is silent, you are able to glimpse the bliss.
So, when the mind is silent, it's called not a mind. A silent mind is not a mind. Noisy mind only is mind. Mind is nothing but thoughts. Okay? If there are no thoughts, it's not a mind. So fire is nothing but heat. If there's no heat, can you call it as a fire? Mind which is silent is not a mind. It is Atma, it is self. It's a no mind. Okay? So let us find out the secrets of bliss. Through truth and myth. It's okay? Now I'll show you why you miss the bliss all the time. Why you miss the bliss all the time. Is this clear? We are focusing only something called bliss. Other things we are not touching. Are you okay?
Peace is saved.
Peace is saved. See, I can see smile on Vadi and Vasudev's face. At least two people recognize the bliss now. Okay. So now, just close your eyes. You are now, must be 40, 50 or 60 year old, whatever age you are. Okay, whatever is that. Close your eyes. And... recognize a time in your life when you are blissful. Okay? So sometime in your life you say, I was blissful, I am blissful, sometime in your life. So you tell me under what, you first recognize that, okay? Then choose a partner, one next to you, and quickly tell, so this is the time I was very blissful. Just make a statement, not details. I was blissful, blah, 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 not half an hour story. Very quickly you tell your neighbor next to somebody and he tells you, or she tells you, this is the point of time I was blissful. Okay? And the same bliss, I'm searching here, and Vani and Vasudev are supposed to give it. So, is the question clear to you? Close your eyes and recollect the time when you are blissful. And open your eyes and tell your neighbor, partner, this is the time I was blissful. Okay? Start. Done. Okay. Okay. So done. Everybody done? Madam, you are completed? You completed the exercise? You have told her? No, you tell her always blissful. Okay? Then why did you spend money to come here? When is it there you have to tell? That is the point. Otherwise, why waste money? So you have to tell? I am blissful at this condition. That's what you have to tell. Are done everybody? Okay? So let us understand. I was blissful. Okay. Tell me one quick word. When?
Sun was born.
Sun was born. Okay, next.
Right now.
Right now. Vani is somehow avoiding peace. Peace issue. She wants to put words into the head of people. Okay, next.
Most
next.
Of the time.
School days. Yes, sir. Somebody else? Sun. Okay, next.
Most of the time in my life.
Huh?
Most of the time in my life.
Oh, that means sometime you don't have bliss. When is it sometime you don't have bliss?
Sometimes.
Sometimes when?
When I'm
having
some sad incident.
Sad incident, I'm missing bliss, no?
Yes.
Okay. So at least I'm happy incident, I'm blissful.
Sir, when I got married.
Wow. Blissfully married. Okay, next. Job. Who is the job? Okay. Next.
I was working with my company.
Working with my company.
Yeah.
Company.
Cricket team won a World Cup.
World Cup. Wow. So, any more special cases are there?
But honestly, if I look back, I can only find moments of happiness as such.
Bliss is not there. No. So you are truthful. No bliss.
Momentary.
See, I can say, when there is you go to a place where like booty and other things. But however...
It's happiness. So you are truthful. Right? Now you have actually extract every rupee of money. She has, without telling you what she is giving, she has brought you to the resort. Make sure that you get full money back.
You are my only hope, sir.
Yes, madam.
Aspirin eats happily.
Wow. Happily, correct? So, anybody else?
Yoga.
Teach yoga.
Do yoga.
Right?
Sleeping. New food.
Okay, I think it's the least useful.
Another
officer.
Modi become Prime Minister.
Modi became PM. Okay, so tell, full. The list is full.
You asked bliss, no?
Huh?
Long happiness, nothing is
permanent. No. First, my question is, you remember in your life when you are blissful?
For a short duration.
Yes. Whatever is that? One minute, half a minute?
It becomes only happiness, sir.
Okay, 1 minute, half a minute, okay. Blissful, I was blissful, you have to say.
When I read the Bhagavad Gita, I am blissful.
Bhagavad Gita.
Think of God.
Okay, I was blissful.
Think of God. Okay. So this, yes, madam, you also.
Sir, I don't know what bliss is.
Yeah, we'll find out. Right? First, I have to find out what bliss is not. So my technique is, my technique is, I teach what is not first, then I'll teach what is. Okay. Are you clear now? Ah, yes, ma'am.
Now I wish for my great granddaughter.
Because of granddaughter.
Great granddaughter.
Oh, second generation.
Fourth generation.
Oh. Okay. So let us give a big round of applause to. Okay. So now, my question is, Nupurji, you not speaken, spoken.
Sir, one night.
Yes, sir.
When I ate first, Masa Dosa, first time at MTR, sir.
Wow, MTR Masa Dosa. Okay. So, is that list is closed now? No more. Okay. Any other special cases there? Okay.
Always.
Okay, always means why did you come here? So you, why you want to spend some few hundred rupees to stay here? Even a blissful person will not go anywhere. Okay? Why should somebody be, blissful person should go somewhere? Okay, I'll give you a story, then you'll understand. Somebody says always blissful, I'll tell a story. Those who are saying always blissful. There was a king, a great king. Okay, he was concerned about people. Concerned about people. And he meditated on God. And typical movie style or television style, the God appeared in front of him. Bhakta, what do you want? The king said, Bhagavan, I don't want anything. Then why did you meditate on me? Bhagavan, I am the king. My all my prajas, that is subjects, should not have hunger at all. In my kingdom there should not be hunger at all. Okay, Bhagavan said, Tathastu. Okay, suddenly the hunger disappeared in the kingdom. Next day king goes to the goes to his Astana or that court. No people are coming, nobody is coming. The soldiers are not there. The whole kingdom, all work has stopped. Then king said, what happened? Okay, the people said, nobody is hungry, why should we do any work? So a person who is blissful will not do any, would put one step forward also. Okay? Because he is full of bliss, for him there is nothing to do. So you have to ask yourself question, really I am a blissful? Or I am just repeating some words? Are you getting what I am saying? So this is a part of the myth. So there is a lot of thinking happens. I am blissful, repeat 10 times, you start thinking I am blissful. But there are words. Are you really blissful? If you are really blissful, in Vedanta says, the person will not even lift his hand to chase away a mosquito. There is no motivation to that also, because you are blissful. Ramana Maharshi, Sri Ramana Maharshi sat for 15 years. His body was, half the body was eaten by mosquitoes. He doesn't even move his hand to remove it because he's already blissful. That is the standard of bliss we have. I mean, to read the standard is okay. It's a golden standard. I'm telling you how the life of a blissful person will be. Right? If you say, always I am blissful, then you have to ask the question, really I am blissful? Then why do I do anything? Okay. Are you clear? So now there's a big list of things. None of this is bliss. What you consider as bliss is not bliss. Okay. Why it's not bliss? Because all of these are conditions applied.
Fine print.
Your fine print is there. I am happy when my great-great-grandchildren are there. Conditions applied. I am happy when I eat masala dosa in MTR. Conditions apply. Okay, tell me which is unconditional here.
Nothing.
Working in a company, you are retired, my dear sir, you are not blissful. And you are searching for a bliss in a resort. How can it happen? Right? Are you getting what I'm saying? If even a small conditions apply, it's not bliss.
That is idealism.
No. That is spirituality. See, what happens is, in the name of spirituality, compromise our understanding. Okay? It's not. I'm speaking of the essence of spirituality is this. So otherwise what happens, we start cheating ourselves. That's a part of the myth. Actually, there's a, what you call, affirmation is there. Day by day, I'm becoming blissful. Day by day, I'm becoming blissful. Day by day, I'm becoming blissful. Then the day you start like repeating like a parrot, I'm blissful. We are not speaking of that. So the person will say, I'm blissful. Really, sir? Yes, I'm blissful. Are you really blissful? Didn't you hear? I am blissful. It requires a mosquito to chase away the bliss. So we are not speaking of that bliss. That is called happiness. Please understand, there is a very difference between happiness and bliss. Happiness is momentary and happiness is always conditions apply. Bliss is always unconditional. No conditions apply is called bliss. Okay? So at least some basic definition of bliss we understood. What is bliss? You'll find out. Anybody has a question on this?
So at least these are all happiness, at least.
This is all what you have tried, sir. I mean, after in your 50 or 60 years of your life, you have tried so many times. If you have got bliss, why should you come here? You tell me. Happiness. Happiness, right?
First, I would like to know what bliss is.
Yeah, first I would like to teach you what is not bliss. See, to understand something, first you have to understand what it's not. Right? Are you clear? Huh?
What remains will be bliss.
So, everybody what you have said is not bliss at all. Okay? This spirituality has nothing to do with this bliss.
Somewhere you can go near to bliss, not through all
this. No. You cannot go near to bliss. Either you are bliss or you are not bliss. So, you either are bliss or you miss the bliss. It is only either or. It is not bliss and something, then it's called happiness, not bliss.
But sir, happiness also there are degrees.
Happiness has a degree, but bliss has no degree. That's why it's absolute. Unconditional, no degree. Degree means the conditions have come.
No percentage.
No percentage. So, please remember this. Is this clear?
It's clear.
So, the buzzword here today for you to remember.
Bliss.
No. Bliss or miss. So, no, alternate to bliss. I have bliss sometimes, I don't have bliss sometimes. No, you have missed it. Either bliss or miss. You cannot go in both the modes. If you have sometimes bliss, then it is happiness, not bliss. Is that much clear to you? Can I go to the next topic now? Time? What is the time?
30, there are solitude.
Last 3 liters of common, sir.
Huh?
Last 3 liters of common.
Yes. Bliss, and the last 3 letters make a lot of difference. So, we want to give a break now.
10:30, we
are
taking a break.
10:32?
10:32 to 7:30 is solitude. 7:30 to 12 is coffee tea. Huh. Then 12 to 1:30 is next session.
Oh, next session already has come. We have not even touched the bliss. You have not even scratched the bliss. Already next session is over.
Sure, it's very difficult.
Okay. So.
12 o'clock, please.
Huh?
12 o'clock, please.
12 o'clock, please. Okay.
You want to take first session from until 11 o'clock.
No, you people decide. So we are. What you want to do? Whatever you say. right? For me to get into this thing, it takes time because I have to go layer by layer myths. What kind of clock?
We'll break at 11.
You want to break at 11? Then what will happen after 12 o'clock again? We'll meet. Okay. So this is all actually called happiness. Okay. Bliss has nothing to do with this. But happiness is actually a small part of bliss. Happiness is a rare bliss. Okay. If bliss is this much, when you say happy, you have seen one ray of bliss. You have not seen bliss, but you have seen sample of bliss, demo of bliss in happiness.
Happiness is time bound.
Happiness is time bound. That's why I'm saying bliss, seen for a short duration, a ray of bliss is called happiness.
And in happiness, there is variety.
Yeah.
There is a Jamun Ananda, there is a Jahangir Ananda.
Bliss, there's no variety.
One variety.
So, when I say this is not bliss, it is called happiness. Happiness is conditional bliss. Okay? Conditions apply, bliss is called happiness. Unconditional happiness is called bliss. So, now this lady asked, what is bliss, right? So, you are in the womb of the mother, okay? When you are in the womb of the mother, everything for you is taken care of. The food, the breathing, okay, right? Your health, medicines. You don't have to ask for anything. And you don't have to worry for anything. You don't have to breathe also. Are you clear? And the state in which you were there was called bliss. This is called bliss. Okay? In the womb of the mother, you don't have any desire left. Any desire. Because you don't have nothing to desire. Bliss is a state of no desire. No desire. Bliss means no desire. Is it according to you? Bliss means no desire. This is another definition of bliss. Are you clear? Even if you have a small desire, that's called happiness, not bliss. I don't have any desire. Absolutely state of desirelessness, just like you are in the womb of the mother, is called bliss. Okay. Now that the child is born. Sorry? The child till some age is very blissful. Okay. So what is the difference between this and this child? The child in the mother's womb doesn't have to breathe anything. No breathing requirement also. No food requirement also. But here the food and breathing requirement comes. The child will have some pain and some pleasure, food. Okay. So here it was not there, and here it is there, but still the child is blissful. The bliss is continuing. Understand? So till what date?
First birthday.
Till you feel jealous of the child. You are so jealous of the child. Kanda, Ninesa Ngota, Ratna, your name is Ratna, Bangaru, you started naming it. In the moment you're naming it, individual issues started coming in. The parents are not comfortable, a blissful child. They want to make it individual. Then they start giving the name to that. The day you started naming it, the child started losing bliss. They're losing awareness of the bliss. Because individualization started. Now here there's no individuality. The child doesn't know who is mother, who is I am. There's no separation. Okay? Here the child is born from mother's womb. It feels uncomfortable, but there's still no separation. The moment individualization started, the moment I started coming into picture, okay, the bliss took the background. Are you clear? So if you want to understand what is bliss, you look at the child. Right? So all of you, many of you understand Kannada here?
Yes.
Yes. There are some Hindi also.
Hindi also. Okay, I'll tell in Kannada. Somebody can effectively translate into Hindi. So there is a saying in Kannada. Makkalagadiddare mukti illa. Have you heard of this?
Yes.
Without children, there's no liberation. Right? Have you heard of it? And what kind of child? Only boy, male child.